And Benoit Pouliot for the Rangers. Pouliot scores! What a move!
That's why the coaches keep giving this guy a chance, isn't it, Dave?
You see
skill like that, all the way to his left, and then he reaches back. Oh, that is a thing of beauty. That's just like the Dave Maloney of old.
That's the Peter Forsberg right there. Wow.
Midway through the period. Long pass up the middle. Kucherov's got it. In behind Ellis. Draws a penalty. Rene to save the score! Kucherov stays with it. The Lightning lead 2-1.
Well, this goal is all about will more than skill. A terrific long pass from beside the net by Nesterov to Kucherov, who's on the fly up the middle. And then Kucherov's going to score this one-handed. Look at Kucherov. Beautiful little play to Kucherov. And look at him. Great strength and just staying with it. Kucherov get one more whack at it. He had already drawn the penalty. Ryan Ellis, number 4, was going for holding or whatever the call was going to be. But Kucherov knew that the puck was in there. Watch him keep his stick in around Pekka-Rinne's stick. Just keep working away at it. He had nothing to lose. Pekka-Rinne had everything to lose. Kucherov wins that one, and it's 2-1.
Waiting for the go-ahead, and he gets it. Trying to drag it, and he scores! Nabokov can't believe it. He can't believe it. He was there. Kucherov dragged it in, trying to go behind him. It went under him and in.
Move, really, and it's kind of been brought out again as you see that play come off his heel of the blade of his stick through the 5-hole. The Lightning have a 2-1 lead now.
So you see who's going next. The fourth shooter looking for the second goal. Zetterberg. Scores! Oh, in Forsberg-like fashion. He went club side in a beautiful move.
Well, that one hurts.
Lead the shootout.
Oh, my goodness. I mean, Zetterberg is not a tall man, and he doesn't have a long reach, but holy jump and Jehoshaphat. Look at that.
Smith thought he was seeing the same thing that he saw from Filppula.
Oh, my, do they love it here if Howard can make this save.
Trying to get to that wraparound spot. Sen's got a lead pass, hopping along. Scores! All that action inside the Ottawa line, and then the long clearing pass, and it's 1-0 Ottawa.
And then what a play here by Carlson. Right over top, high over the forwards, right on the tape. I mean, on the tape of Hoffman, who's been quiet in this series. And he does the old hockey school move. He goes up, back with the one hand, completely fools Tukaras.
Gave it away to Radulov, who steps in, played it ahead. Dano, Radulov rumbling in there. Oh, what a goal! The Rangers cut two ribbons on that play, and it's 3-0 Montreal.
Turnovers have been a big issue in this game for the New York Rangers, and the neutral zone has been a haven for them. And there's a disconnect between the Ranger defense and their forwards. This is a problem they were having a good portion of the back end of the season, and here Klein puts it right on Radulov's stick, and then he walks right in and does the Peter Forsberg. I mean, this is not an easy thing to do with a guy draped all over you, and it just shows the strength and the agility and the talent of Alexander Radulov, who not only got the Canadiens back in this series with a great pass to Plekanec to tie it, an overtime game-winning goal, and tonight, maybe the sealer in Game 3.
And Tarasenko, his second shootout this year.
I'm going to call snapper low to the stick side.
And Tarasenko in on Ronta.
He works and he scores! That got across the line! A one-handed move! That's a Peter Forsberg move there!
He must have been watching the World Juniors today. The Czech going up against Canada, and the game-winning goal was similar to that. Just enough to get it over the line, off the toe, and in the net! What a play!
Forsberg scored a goal in the Olympics against Corey Hirsch to win a gold medal, just like that. So the Blues lead it 2-1.
Roberto using a stick there.
Alexander Barkov, another shot for the Cats to win it in the seventh round. Barkov, let's go home, baby! The Cats do it again!
What was that? Oh, my. That is so sneaky.
And look at this from the teenager beating Fleury. That's he is the fifth Panther this year to get a game-deciding goal in the shootout. And look at this look from our cameras. That is just beautiful.
It's just amazing. I mean, all due respect to Marc-Andre Fleury, that is the kind of goal that makes you look a little silly. The fact is, it wasn't a hard shot. It was a well-placed shot. And Barkov sure had me fooled. But he had it in his mind how he was going to beat probably the hottest goaltender in the NHL right now, and he did.
Sees part for Crosby to the goal. He scores! Another backhander by Sid gives the Penguins a 1-0 lead with just 8.2 ticks on the clock. A power play goal off the rush.
It was a one-hander, wasn't it? I think it was a one-hand wrist shot up in the air by the glove hand. Sidney Crosby, he's got it all. Pulling out the tricks from the bag. Right through the middle of the ice. One-handed wrist shot on the backhand. Absolutely. You try that at home. I'm telling you, folks, that's near impossible. This, it's near impossible as well. Running the gamut, one-handed wrist shot. You talk about wrist ain't there.
Blues power play only two for their last 21. The Rangers have killed 16 in a row at home. Oh, Tarasenko! Oh, my shot! And he scores with an unbelievable one-handed tuck-in goal! And the Blues have tied the game on a highlight reel goal!
These hands are sick. That is some play right there. He's improved his speed and his conditioning in the offseason. Takes the pass here as Shattenkirk plays it back to Tarasenko. One, two, then going to the forehand to the backhand, one hand on the stick and behind the goaltender who's got no chance on the play. This is just absolutely brilliant right here. And you're going to see this every night on the highlight film for weeks to come.
Peter Forsberg. Rehut.
Vilken fräckaste teknik!
Så där kunde Ulf Sterner göra på sin tid. Ja, det är bara kanonlirare och Kenta Nilsson. Han gör ett Kenta Nilsson-mål. Han drar Hurt så att Hurt är uppe på läktaren. Och då lägger han den i tom bur.